Yes, yes. We have here a table.
Do you hold this, please?
This is a table of, as we all know, the amounts involved was $950 million. Okay? $81 million went through the system, went to RCBC. And another $20 million was the subject of a stop order by the Federal Reserve, which was on its way to Sri Lanka. Okay. We're talking about 35 payment instructions totaling $951 million. Now, five payment instructions went through. This one covers the 30 payment instructions that did not go through. What is notable here is that all payment instructions were created on the same day, February 5, 2016. What time? They were created in all 30 payment instructions totaling $850 million. It's created in 2 seconds. 12 midnight and 51 seconds to 12 midnight, 51 minutes and 51 seconds, 12 midnight, 51 minutes to 52 seconds. 2 seconds, $850 million payment instructions were created. Now, it's all stated here that the beneficiary bank or the bank to which the payment instructions were to be sent, the $850 million, all of it is in the name of RCBC. All of it, $850 million. And then from RCBC, the $850 million would have gone to the five fictitious accounts. Ralph Picache, Michael Cruz, Jesse Lagrosas, Alfred Vergara, and Rico Vasquez. Five fictitious accounts, each having $30 million payment instructions, $30 or $20 million. Five. And then after that, another five names, the same name. So it goes round and round by succession. Iniikot-ikot lang, succeeding names. So that is what we see, and that is what would have happened had the Federal Reserve Bank of New York if the Federal Reserve Bank of New York honored the payment instructions. Luckily, because of their diligence, they did stop this 30 payment orders. In fact, the Federal Reserve sent a telex or a message to the Bank of Bangladesh, and they were asking the following information. Number one, they say, "We would greatly appreciate if you could provide us with more information on these transactions. Specifically, please provide the following. Number one, full information of the beneficiaries, Alfred Vergara, Jesse Christopher Lagrosas, Michael Cruz, Enrico Velasquez, Ralph Picache." Then they go on, they said, "Please include their occupation, connection to the originating party, which is the central, which is the Bank of Bangladesh, and a website reference if possible." Then number two, "What is the professional relationship, if any, between the five individual beneficiaries?" Then number three, "Full details of the underlying goods or services covered by these payments." I suppose they suppose that these were for the purchase of goods or services. So they were asking details. And number four, which is very intriguing, "Why are these payments that represent repayment of institutional loans being made to these individual beneficiaries?" So in other words, they were wondering why a central bank is dealing with individual beneficiaries. As we all know, central banks do not deal with individuals. So what is remarkable here is that had it gone through, it would have all 850 million or 951 million minus the 20 million for Sri Lanka would have all gone to RCBC and then into the accounts of the fictitious persons. That would be the line of reasoning that Senator Osmeña was trying to cull.